हरिओम, आई एम निधिमा पाणिग्रही ऑफ क्लास 10B. हिज ग्रेटनेस लाइज इन हिज अबिलिटी टू रेज द मेनेस्ट क्रिएचर टू बिकम एज ग्रेट एज हिम. इन एवरी सिचुएशन ही शोड हिज सचिदानंद नेचर. हिज डिविनिटी वॉज ट्रांसलेटेड इन टू एवरी डे लाइफ आइडल इन डेली प्रैक्टिकल रियलिटी. ही डिस्टिंग्विश्ड हिमसेल्फ एज अ ग्रेट एंड नोबल श्री रामचंद्र. True understandings are surely drawn if we follow the principles of the Dharma of Sri Rama. The Dharma of Sri Rama. The famous Ramayana, immortalized by sage Valmiki, though found in many Puranas, is not a Purana but an Itihasa. It appears to be in the Puranas because one of the subjects dealt with in the Puranas is Vamsanukarita, or the histories of the Vamshas, the Solar Dynasty and the Lunar Dynasty. Sri Ramachandra is a descendant of the Solar Dynasty, and the story of his life contributes to the history of the Solar Dynasty. Itihasa, as we know it, is Ghatana Pradhana. It focuses on the factual happening in another period of time. Purana, on the other hand, sometimes cloaked with the historical events, convey a teaching. They instruct and guide the mankind by pointing out the idol and also showing the path for its accomplishment. The Rama Avatara, however, necessarily implemented for Martya Sikshanartham, that is, it is meant to educate all the mortals. His life and the incidents in it thus become a personification to education. Since this fulfills the process of Puranas, though it being an Itihasa, is considered to be a Purana. Thank you.
Hari Om.
चले न श्री राम के बिना, राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना. दुनिया चले न श्री राम के बिना, राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना. जग से रामायण पढ़ ली है, एक बात मैंने समझ ली है. जब से रामायण पढ़ ली है, एक बात मैंने समझ ली है. रावण मरे न श्री राम के बिना, लंका जले न हनुमान के बिना. दुनिया चले न श्री राम के बिना, राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना. सीता हरण की कहानी सुनो, बनवारी मेरी जुबानी सुनो. सीता हरण की कहानी सुनो, बनवारी मेरी जुबानी सुनो. सीता मिले न श्री राम के बिना, पता लगे न हनुमान के बिना. दुनिया चले न श्री राम के बिना, राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना. लक्ष्मण का बचना मुश्किल था, कौन बूटी लाने की काबिल था. लक्ष्मण का बचना मुश्किल था, कौन बूटी लाने की काबिल था. लक्ष्मण बचे न श्री राम के बिना, बूटी मिले न हनुमान के बिना. दुनिया चले न श्री राम के बिना, राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना. बैठे सिंहासन पे सियाराम जी, चरणों में बैठे हैं हनुमान जी. बैठे सिंहासन पे सियाराम जी, चरणों में बैठे हैं हनुमान जी. मुक्ति मिले न श्री राम के बिना, भक्ति मिले न हनुमान के बिना. मुक्ति मिले न श्री राम के बिना, भक्ति मिले न हनुमान के बिना. दुनिया चले न श्री राम के बिना, राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना. दुनिया चले न श्री राम के बिना, राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना. राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना, राम जी चले न हनुमान के बिना.
Adarsha Purusha and Maryada Purushottam. Adarsha Purusha literally means the ideal person. Was he considered the idle person because he had many idols? In that case, any idealistic person could be called an Adarsha Purusha. Here, Adarsha Purusha refers to a heroic heart that has stood stout through trials, tribulation, struggles, and tests encountered on the path to the perfection. With a resolute heart filled with faith and courage, he overcomes them. He is then united, as it were, with the perfection that verily translates the ideals into a concrete reality. No longer separate from the ideals, he became the ideal itself. He then represents and features that idol by his very existence. Shri Ram was such an Adarsha Purusha.
Oh,
Maryada Purushottama literally means the best among men, following a standard of righteous living. Does this mean that Sri Rama mechanically followed the Dharma Maryada? Well, he did not merely follow Dharma, but in fact established the Dharma Maryada. He set standards of Dharma Maryada by an exemplary life, which was the very embodiment of righteousness. And to appreciate his greatness, we have to study the Ramayana in its entirety. Thank you.
Prema mudita manse kaho Ram Ram Ram. Prema mudita manse kaho Ram Ram Ram. Shri Ram Ram Ram. Paap kate dukh mite le ta Ram Naam. Paap kate dukh mite le ta Ram Naam. Bhava samudra sukhada naav ek Ram Naam. Bhava samudra sukhada naav ek Ram Naam. Shri Ram Ram Ram. Shri Ram Ram Ram. Shri Ram Ram Ram. Param shanti sukh nibhana nita Ram Naam. Param shanti sukh nibhana nita Ram Naam. Niradhar ko adhar ek Ram Naam. Niradhar ko adhar ek Ram Naam.
Kingdom of God, enshrined of all beings. Bharata and the citizens of Ayodhya were against this. Rama undoubtedly had the majority on his side. He is not light-sighted like today's day's politicians, seeing immediate gains. His entire life was on dharma. His decisions were based on the standpoint and not for immediate gains. Being the veritable avatar of dharma, he could not stoop the ascent of the throne by adharmika means. Essence of religion. There are few striking examples that are self-explanatory. For instance, Sri Rama, being the eldest son and the prince of Chola dynasty, was an apparent. Raja Dasaratha, the father of Sri Rama, was an idealistic man. He wanted Ramarajya to prevail. So he thought that placing Rama on the throne of Ramarajya would naturally prevail. So he decided to crown the young prince and make him the regent. At this point, Kaikeyi, Rama's stepmother, raised an objection. She dramatically opposed the proposition, suggesting that Rama would exile for a period of 14 years and her son Bharata would be placed on the throne. Rama also supported Ramarajya by not merely placing himself on the throne of Ayodhya. He wanted to be seated on the hearts of all citizens of Ayodhya, which is the everlasting throne of love within. He also wanted to be accepted unanimously without any discordant note of protest and dissatisfaction. Only then he would consider himself fit to wear the crown of sovereignty. This indeed is nobility. Others may have attempted to gain the kingdom by their force. Some may have gone to the extent of the assassinating the old king. But Sri Rama strictly followed the dictates of dharma. This was the uniqueness of his maryada. For him, his idol came first, next his people, and at last himself. This is essence of religion. Love God and serve thy fellow man. Only through love he would ruled over the hearts of all. Not wanting a perishable throne and empire, he desired the everlasting kingdom of God. Enshrined of all beings, the string of dharma runs throughout the Ramayana. By asking Rama for exile and Bharata's coronation, Kaikeyi went against dharma. No one was favor of this. Only Kaikeyi and her wicked maid Manthara were in minority. Raja Dasaratha, Bharata and the citizens of Ayodhya were against this. Rama undoubtedly had the majority on his side. He is not light-sighted like today's day's politicians, seeing immediate gains. His entire life was on dharma. His decisions were based on the standpoint and not for immediate gains. Being the veritable avatar of dharma, he could not stoop the ascent of the throne by adharmika means. Of the stepmother had he allowed himself to be crowned, because there was a possibility that at some later date the people of Ayodhya would point at Raja Dasaratha and he would have gone down in the history because of one who was unable to fulfill his wife's request and one who fell short of his promise. This would have amounted to the expression of mistrust and disbelief. The king of his successor ability to fulfill the needs of the subjects. This premise would have tarnished history of the glorious solar dynasty. Besides, they may have also labeled Sri Rama as one of the avidly desiring the throne and thirsty of power and sovereignty.
Mangala Bhavana Mangalhari Dravo Sudasaratha
अमंगलहारी द्रवो सुदसरथ जी। राजा के स्वभाव से ही सुंदर वचन सुनकर रानियों ने मनियों से जुड़े स्वर्ण के पलंग बिछवाए। गद्दों पर गांव के दूध के फेन के समान सुंदर एवं कोमल अनेकों सफेद चादरें बिछाई। सुंदर तकियों का वर्णन नहीं किया जा सकता था। मनियों के मंदिर में फूलों की मालाएं और सुगंध द्रव्य सजे हैं। सुंदर रत्नों के दीपकों और सुंदर चंदोवे की शोभा कहते नहीं बनती। जिसने उन्हें देखा हो वही जान सकता है। श्री राम इस प्रकार माताओं ने श्री राम जी को उठाया और प्रेम सहित पलंग पर पौढ़ाया। श्री राम जी के सांवले सुंदर कोमल रंगों को देखकर माताएं प्रेम सहित वचन कहते हैं। हे तात, मार्ग में जाते हुए तुमने बड़ी भयावनी ताड़का राक्षसी को किस प्रकार से मारा? जो विकट योद्धा थे और जो किसी को कुछ नहीं गिनते थे, उन दुष्ट मारीच और सुबाहु को तुमने सहायकों सहित कैसे मारा? हे तात, मैं बलैया लेती हूँ। मुनि के कृपा से ईश्वर ने तुम्हारी बहुत सी बलाओं को टाल दिया। दोनों भाइयों ने यज्ञ की रखवाली करके गुरु जी के प्रसाद से सब विद्याएं पाई। चरणों की धूल लगते ही मुनि पत्नी अहल्या तर गई। विश्व भर में यह कीर्ति पूर्ण रीति से व्याप्त हो गई। कच्छप की पीठ वज्र और पर्वत से भी कठोर शिव जी के धनुष को तुमने राजाओं के समाज में तोड़ दिया। विश्व विजय के यश और जानकी को पाया और सब भाइयों को ब्याह कर घर आए। तुम्हारे सभी कर्म अमानुषी है, यानी मनुष्य के शक्ति के बाहर है, जिन्हें केवल विश्वामित्र जी के कृपा ने ही सुधारा है। हे तात, तुम्हारा चंद्रमुख देखकर आज हमारा जगत में जन्म लेना सफल हुआ, यानी हम आज हमारे जीवन में सफल हो पाए। तुमको बिना देखे जो दिन बीते हैं, उन्हें ब्रह्मा गिनती में बिल्कुल भी ना लावे, यानी हमारी आयु में शामिल ना करे। विनय भरे उत्तम वचन कहकर श्री राम जी ने सब माताओं को संतुष्ट किया। फिर शिव जी गुरु और ब्राह्मणों के चरणों को स्मरण कर नेत्रों को नील के वश किया, अर्थात वे सो रहे। जय सियाराम।
Dharma Maryada. Sri Rama herein affirms that a word once given will never stand compromised or a promise go unfulfilled. The throne of truth and righteousness was the only throne that he sought. This is Dharma Maryada. This amounts to the extension of our Sachidananda Swarupaha into the grosser realms of relative existence, the very basis of the philosophy of life. Again, we observe that Sri Rama was not to be seated on the throne above the common man, issuing orders and ruling and advising his subjects like a furor. Instead, he mingled and became one with his subjects. Although hailing from the noble, blue-blooded Aryan race and the Shuryavamsha, his simple nature brought him down to the level of the common man. He lived life lovingly and humbly, shoulder to shoulder with them. We find several examples of this during his 14 years in exile, when he donned bear bark as a garment, exposing his gentle skin to the fierce weather, living on roots and fruits, and exposing himself to privations. Here, he befriended the Vanavasis, the tribals, the boatmen, the rishis and the ascetics, and even the birds and the beasts. He lived with them, lent a sympathetic ear to their difficulties, and alleviated their sufferings at every turn. The entire forest became his family, and he undoubtedly won their love, reverence, and confidence. This is Dharma Maryada. To establish dharma, one must be willing to sacrifice one's petty, insignificant stature, to rise and unite with the totality by seeing oneness or the one Atma-tattva in all existence. We find Sri Rama apparently distraught, pining for his lost Sita. But the truth is really not so. He was by no means a carnal, passionate human, tortured by gross attachments. Connected with all beings, he suffered deeply and felt everybody's pain. At various points during his search for Sita, he seems to forget her entirely. He sees a bleeding and fallen Jatayu and is moved to tears by his noble sacrifice and suffering. Sabari's faith and devotion touched him deeply and he was filled with love and joy. Similarly, when he heard of Sita's miserable plight, he felt her pain deeply as well. He met the love and affection of people by spreading the fragrance of his own love. When he saw sacrifice and suffering, he was reduced to tears, which arose from his deep love and compassion for all beings. Once, he discovered a heap of bones lying in a forest, which belonged to the rishis and the ascetics, or those who had been mercilessly slain by the Rakshasas. In this instance, though he had to kill or slay the Adharmika, his aggressive annihilation of the Asuras was only to protect the innocent, the good, and to uphold Dharma. And even when he did kill the wrongdoers, he transported them directly to Vishnupada, his divine abode. Thus, they gained the Paramadhama of the Lord. So in fact, he gave true life through whatever he did and wherever he went. We also find that in different situations, he gave counsel and imparted knowledge. For example, when he visited Sabari, he was overcome by her faith and devotion and instructed her on Navadha Bhakti. He also instructed Lakshmana on the subtleties of Vairagya, Viveka, Maya, and at times even Rajaniti. To Tara, who was weeping over the death of Bali, he imparted self-knowledge, which removed her ignorance and filled her with ananda. He was filled with love and compassion for all beings and gave himself in every way at every level. After finally killing Ravana, he instructed Vibhishana to perform the final rites, considering Ravana as his brother. In every situation, Sri Rama revealed his Satchidananda nature. His divinity was translated into everyday living, the ideal in daily practical reality. He thus distinguished himself as the Adarsha Purusha, the Maryada Purushottama, the great and noble Sri Ramachandra. His greatness lay in his ability in raising even the meanest creature to become as great as himself. He did this not by trampling over others or by intimidating them or by sitting in lordship over them as Ravana did. Instead, he believed in searching for the lurking potential within each one so that it could manifest or bloom in full splendor. He did this with Hanumana, who until then had been humbly inconspicuous, and with Vibhishana and also with Bharata. The whole world would have been entirely ignorant of these great devotees had it not been for Sri Ramachandra to bring them into limelight. Perceiving this one great essence pervading the entire universe is greatness indeed. To live thereafter, glorifying, worshipping and extolling this divinity through all actions, however humble and insignificant, and offering it all as worship at the altar of the universal spirit is the dharma preached by Sri Ramachandra. This was the principle upon which he based his glorious life. While commencing on a sincere study of the Ramayana, if the internal values taught to us by the Puranas are kept in mind, then true understanding...
राम प्रभु की।